Hello everyone, and welcome to How Fix It. In today's guide, I'll show you how to upgrade the SSD in a MacBook Pro 15-inch 2015 to a modern 2TB M.2 drive. I'll also cover how to do a clean installation of macOS and, if needed, transfer your data from the old drive. This upgrade will give your MacBook faster performance, more storage, and extend its lifespan for years to come. For this repair, you'll need two screwdrivers, a Pentalobe and a T4 Torx, along with a couple of plastic spudgers for safe disassembly. To install a modern M.2 SSD, you'll also need a special adapter. For this upgrade, I chose the 2TB SSD from Orico. It offers industrial-grade quality, fast read speeds, comes with a heatsink, and has been tested to work with the MacBook Pro. The kit includes a spare screw, not needed, since we'll use the stock screw, instructions for applying cooling the M.2 SSD itself, a thermal silicone gasket, and an aluminum heatsink. It also comes with a Phillips No. 1 screwdriver, though we won't need it for this repair. For convenience, I've added links to the screwdriver set, adapter, and M.2 SSD in the video description below. If you want to transfer your data from the old drive, make a backup before starting. Open Time Machine Preferences from System Preferences. Go to Options to check how much storage space you'll need. Make sure you have a flash drive or external drive with enough capacity. Use the plus and minus buttons to exclude folders if needed. You can also allow backups while on battery power. Connect your external drive to your MacBook, on which you will create a backup copy. Click the Select Backup Disk button and select your external drive. Enable notifications if you want, then wait for the backup to complete. Once the backup is done, power off your MacBook completely before starting the repair. Make sure the laptop is fully powered off. Close it, flip it over, and remove the 10 screws with a 1.2mm Pentalobe screwdriver. Remember, the two middle screws along the top edge are shorter than the others, so keep track of them for reassembly. Lift off the bottom cover from the top edge. Peel back the sticker covering the battery connector. Gently lift the battery connector out of its socket, then bend it back toward the battery so it doesn't accidentally reconnect. Now, use a T4 Torx screwdriver to remove the single screw holding the SSD. Lift the end of the SSD just enough to clear the speaker, then pull it straight out. Now you can remove and replace the old SSD drive. As you can see, the old SSD uses a proprietary connector, so we'll use the adapter to install the modern M.2 SSD. Insert the adapter into the SSD slot, then install the new M.2 SSD and secure it with a screw. You may encounter a problem where the screw won't tighten. If the screw doesn't tighten, the circular ring on the SSD may slightly block the screw seat due to the adapter being longer. Try tightening at a slight angle or carefully file down about 0.5mm from the board. Be extremely careful. That small adjustment is enough. Now that the SSD is secured, we can install an additional heatsink. A heatsink is optional but recommended. My SSD kit comes with a thermal pad and heatsink, but due to limited space inside the MacBook, I'll install the heatsink directly on the SSD board without the thermal pad. If you have the same kit, peel off the adhesive backing, then place the heatsink so it doesn't overlap the circular ring at the rear of the SSD. Reconnect the battery connector to the motherboard. Put back the sticker covering the battery connector. Reinstall the bottom cover onto the MacBook Pro and tighten the screws. Remember that the top two screws in the middle of the lid are shorter than the other eight, so keep an eye on each screw as you reassemble. you can now turn on your MacBook and begin installing macOS. Press the power button, then immediately hold Command plus Option plus R to enter Internet Recovery mode. When prompted, select and connect to the Wi-Fi network. A progress bar will appear as the recovery loads. Once macOS Utilities appears, select Disk Utility. In the left panel, choose your new SSD. Click the Erase button toward the top of the Disk Utility window. Name the drive. For format, choose APFS if you're installing macOS High Sierra or newer. If you're installing an older system, choose macOS Extended Journaled. Click Erase again to confirm, then close Disk Utility. Back in Utilities, select Reinstall macOS. Select the newly formatted disk as the target for the installation. The system will download and install macOS. This may take some time depending on your internet speed. After installation, your Mac will restart. Follow the setup assistant to choose language, Wi-Fi, Apple ID, and other settings. At this step, you can select your preferred language. At the Migration Assistant screen, you have two options. For a clean installation, select Not Now in the lower left corner of the window. To restore data, connect your Time Machine backup drive, choose Transfer from Time Machine, and follow the prompts. Here you can select or exclude folders before the data transfer process. Then follow the prompts to install macOS. And that's it. You now have a modern 2TB SSD installed in your MacBook Pro 2015 with a fresh installation of macOS. As you can see, the SSD is correctly detected with its full memory capacity. If you found this guide helpful, give us a thumbs up and subscribe for more repair and upgrade tutorials. Visit our website for more tech insights and DIY guides. Remember, every tech challenge is an opportunity to learn and grow. Thanks for watching How Fix It, and see you in the next one.